I think there's a strange phenomenon on YouTube of the algorithm is the reason everything in my life is bad. And it's not
the most YouTube sentence I've ever heard.
Yeah, and it's actually something that I strongly disagree with. I see YouTubers rise and fall all the time. I've been on the platform as long as some of the other people here, and a lot of people go, oh, it's the algorithm. Like, is this something I'm gonna raise on the animation panel? I'm not an animator, but I am on the animation panel tomorrow. And a lot of people say the algorithm killed animation, but I'm actually gonna argue that as someone who does sketch comedy and animation, I saw that audiences just kind of changed what they wanted in around 2013, because I do both, and suddenly animations went on my channel went from getting 5 million views and sketches getting 1 to sketches getting 5 and animation getting 1. That wasn't the algorithm, that was people's opinions changing. So, but I'm kind of going on a tangent, and I'm gonna stop talking.
I think it's definitely important to be mindful of who's watching and be aware of like how they might perceive something. And sometimes you do take that on board when you're in the ideas process. But also you need to kind of challenge your audience a little bit and sort of like make sure that you're, for example, like if I wanna make a video that is quite, you know, has some dark twists and turns and like that's the stuff that I find funniest, then I wanna really do push that and do that and then, yeah, really just make some head spin, I guess.
That's really funny because I was about to use the example of when I uploaded a video called Happy and it was just like this lovely little animation about happiness and it screened a buffer and afterwards people were like, where was Hazel's video? I was like, yeah, I can be happy too. sometimes I'm nice. But we have the exact opposite thing where people expect this happy, floaty from you and they expect this horrible dark stuff from me, and when we veer out of that they're like, what are you doing? Stay in your lane.
Well, I think almost like just as a human it's just healthier to like try and do different stuff, and obviously for some people it's like on a very boring financial level, you know, they have to do occasionally stuff that plays it safe, you know, like for Tom, you're one of my favorite YouTubers, but like I appreciate that you have to watch out for two people's salaries, you know, you hire two people, so you know, I still love the stuff you make, but I understand your necessity to be like, right, you know, so often when you're writing stuff, you're like, I like that, but you know, let's change it. You're so particular about it, and I, you know, like, I absolutely adore it, but it's interesting that you have to factor that in. But you also do, you know, you do Crash Zoom, right? And it's like, it's not your flagship show. It's not Astiff movie, right? Like, it's not raking in as many people, but it's something you get a lot of fulfillment out of. And I'd really admire that. You know, I love that you still continue with it.
Well, a lot of people, because a lot of the, my channel's kind of torn between two worlds, and that does create some weird kind of friction on my channel, because you know, like, I'm most popular for like these whoa animations, but then I also like doing live action sketches. So what you'll see is that my channel has this weird relationship where it goes, it's like beep boop, and these are the view counts. Just suddenly, here's a low one, here's a high one, here's a low one, and people expect me to have a lot of resentment to my flagship series. But I also am fully aware that without that series, there wouldn't, these low troughs would be even lower. You know, like. And to be fair, the only thing that separates me from, and there's no way to say this without sounding like an asshole, the only thing that separates my channel's viewing figures from yours, Sammy, is that I have Astiff Movie.
Also, Sammy hasn't tried to grow his channel enough.
I have Astiff Movie, and you're a piece of
right.
Yeah.
But like, I'm just grateful that YouTube has allowed me a way to create an audience for my content that I'm perhaps more proud of in a different way. It's like I've got two kids, and I'm. They're both great, but in different ways. Like, one of them I'm proud of because it's like, oh, you got dressed this morning, and the other. I don't even know where to go from here.